Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBM RPG sample video. In this video, I'm going to share a super useful trick for working with DB2 for I in VS Code. A lot of people ask me how to easily export data from the IBM, so I'm going to show you an easy way to export your query results to different formats, making it simple to share or analyze your data. If you work with DB2 for I or you have not started to use it, you don't want to miss this. Let's go. Okay, let's start with DB2 for I. As you know, DB2 for I is a fantastic extension that works as a great complement to Code for I. This is not the first video I have made talking about it, but I wanted to create a new one just talking about this. If you need to see data inside tables or simply run a query, it is a very solid option, sometimes even better than ACS. Well, once you are connected to your IBM, all you need to do is click on the DB2 for I icon, that is this one. Then just by clicking here, you can create a new document where you can write your queries. For example, let me show you the data that is inside this table. Select everything from this table. Colors. If I run the query, clicking here or just clicking Command R or Control R, here is the result. Of course, you can create more complex queries, no problem. Well, now imagine that you need to export this data into a text file like a CSV. How would you do it? Well, it is as easy as this. I can add a prefix to the query specifying CSV. This way, CSV, and if I run the query, I instantly get a result in CSV format. Quick and easy. And it doesn't matter if the table contains numbers or alphanumeric data. It handles everything correctly. Another great option is exporting the query result in a different format, like JSON. Let me go again to the query, and well, we have just to replace CSV with JSON, and if I run it, this is what I get, the same data but now in JSON format. Pretty cool, right? But there's one more format I want to show you, SQL, and you might be wondering, what is that? Well, let me show it to you. If I replace JSON for SQL, here it is. It's an insert statement that you can use to add the data to another table or even to the same one. Of course, you can use any of these export options with any table or any query, no matter how complex it is. So give it a try and let me know how it goes. So in this video, we explored three powerful ways to export data from DB2 for I in VS Code: CSV, JSON, and SQL. Each of them can be really useful depending on what you need to do. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.